Next one up, A Utopian Catches a Cold by Joe Gauer. Interior, Hall of Decisions, also daytime. The Hall of Decisions is a cavernous chamber of daylight, permeable material that a 21st century boat would assume was glass, until it flickers and hums like the futuristic hard light force field it is. A large structure in the center of a round interior stands tall over the congregation of Utopian elders, like a church altar. Everyone wears bright white tunics. One Utopian, Larry, early 40s, can't help but look around in awe. To himself,
"You're finally in the big leagues, Larry."
As busy, slender-looking good-looking people with just the right amount of George Clooney salt and pepper hair to suggest wisdom, brush past him in all directions, our more portly, balding hero pays them no mind. He marches on, looking up, over and every which way with amazement. This is his mecca. Meanwhile, atop the central altar, an elder that actually looks good and looks like an elder, but with that Michael Douglas good looks, makes his way to the speaking podium. The crowd eventually notices and begins to hush. Voice elevated.
Our friends.
The crowd quiets down. Larry finally pays attention.
As you have probably noticed, there is a guest among our ranks today.
The hundreds in attendance part, almost in synchronization, to make room around Larry. All eyes are on him now. Nervous.
Hi.
The crowd stares back blankly, like an aquarium full of goldfish.
It's okay, Larry. There's a lot to take in all at once.
Larry gulps.
All of your long years of dutiful service to your government, and now it seems your destiny has finally brought you here.
The crowd whispers amongst itself.
So, is he really one of them now? I didn't think that was possible, but I am not one to question what I hear. The diseased ones now carry conditions that can't be fixed.
What do you mean can't be fixed? Everything is fixable.
Realizing he's losing the crowd, the elder speaks up.
Now, I think our good friend Larry Cogsworth is long overdue for some gratitude, so let's recognize that now.
A few good-natured attendants try to start a slow clap over the rabble. They are unsuccessful. The elder takes charge, annoyed.
Clap for the man, damn it!
The crowd starts clapping from the elder's point of view up high, but back on the floor, people are still staring at Larry with distrust, even as they show their appreciation. Larry looks around them, uncomfortably. Not enthused.
Thank you. And never lose faith in the system, etc. You know, there was a little more rejoicing involved than I envisioned.
A loud, chesty cough erupts from him. He scrambles to cover his mouth. The clapping closest to him stops abruptly.
Okay, what the hell was that? It looked like some kind of convulsion. Disease.
All right, calm down. Show of hands, who here was implanted with pathogen-targeting nanobot deployers?
The others stare back at him. A few slowly raise their hands. Plainly.
That should be all of you.
He turns to Larry, smugly.
Geez, these Central City elders, never seen an unclean before.
Larry's taken aback.
Wait, what did you just call me?
I didn't mean any offense. I voted against the war. I'll have you know, I think your people are perfectly...
I'm a Utopian, too. I'm from Central City.
He yanks on his tunic.
You see this? You think I want to dress this way?
The elder tries to quell the chatter one last time.
Order! I said order.
Someone yells from the crowd.
Get to the point already.
Exasperated.
Fine. If everybody shuts up for 2 seconds, I'll tell you what our plan is. This guy.
The crowd finally shuts up, and very paranoid Larry raises his hand.
Excuse me?
What's now?
Larry sheepishly approaches the altar.
Sir, I don't really know your title. I think you'd be committing a slight violation of the human happiness code, and it might upset the greater intelligence.
Some gasp over this, many whisper.
Ooh, that's a bold statement, my friend.
The elder says nothing. He pushes